Good morning, class course. Welcome to today's class. This lesson we are going to look at the basics. And today we are going to look at how to write hundreds. In the previous lesson, we looked at how to write tens. If I give a number like 9 over 10, this is a fraction. So if you convert into decimal, you be guided by the number of zeros on the denominator. Number of zeros have in the denominator is 1. Hence, this will give you 0. Make sure after decimal, you have the number, the digits here after decimal equivalent to the number of zero you have here. If you have 10, then make sure that after a decimal point, this is my decimal point, you have one digit. So here I have 10, I'll have one digit, and this is 9, you have 9. Alternatively, we have a decimal here at the end of that number. If you have 10, that means you are moving how many steps? One step towards your left hand side. Hence, this will be like that, and put that decimal right there. So hence, will be 0.9. That's what we discussed last lesson. Today, we want to move on how to write 100. And before that, we want to look on how to come up with fraction by shading. And then once you have the fraction, convert them into hundreds. For example, if you want to draw, follow my steps, follow my guidelines, so as to avoid rubbing. Take your ruler, draw a vertical line going down, and here draw a horizontal line. A horizontal line. Don't close it, just leave it open like that. Then from there, I want to draw 100 boxes. I want to have 100 boxes here. And these are the steps that again how you need to draw it. Put your ruler, you write, you draw 10 verticals, and then you draw 10 horizontal. All of them together will give you 100. That is 1, 2, 9, 10. Once you have 10, you can wrap that part because you have 10 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10 columns. Now you draw rows, also make sure that 10, so 10, 10 will give us 100. Count confirming that 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 on you rub extended lines. Make sure I use pencils for easy rubbing. Here we are. So I have a figure. The figure has been divided into a total of 100 parts. Now from there, we can use my finger to illustrate or demonstrate some examples on how to write handwrites. First of all, by writing fraction. For example, let's say we have certain part of our finger shaded. We have a certain part of the finger shaded. So first of all, how many parts are shaded? You need to count them. How many parts are shaded parts? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 30 parts are shaded. Then all parts, how many are they? All parts you count. Count all of them to find out how many are they. Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 4, 7, 5, 7, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 8, 8, 9, 8, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100. There are 100. How many parts? There are 100 parts. Easy counting if you want to count them easily. You count rows. How many rows do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 rows. Columns, how many columns do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, that's 10. So total number will be, you multiply the number of boxes here, which is 10, by the number of boxes here, which is 10. So it will be 10 multiplied by 10, and this gives you 100, show that you have 100 boxes, if you are looking for the total number of boxes, all parts of them. Since fraction here, fraction of the shaded part, will be shaded part, which is 30, over all parts together. All parts are 100. That's how you work it out. Then from there, I will need you to write this as a decimal. As a decimal, I say divided by denominator. Don't you have 100? 100, what does it mean? Two zeros. Hence, write at 0 point after a point. How many digits will you have? One. You need to have two digits. Hence, this will be 0.30. That's a decimal. Alternatively, as a fraction, you have 30 over 10, over 100, I mean, I'm sorry. Put a decimal at the end. Whole number have the decimal at their end. Then move this small, how many steps? One, two. You move this. You move this small two steps. Going where? Going to your left hand side. Going to your left hand side. Then you move one, two. Put a decimal there. So your answer will be 0.30, which is the equivalent as 0.3, but just at 0.30. That is it about that. Let me talk about an example. Due to time drawing, allow me to be a bit sketchy here. You have a figure like that. That's 100 guy. That's 100 parts. And I'm going to shape. So what is the decimal of shape part? What is the decimal of shape part? First of all, get all parts together. How many of them together? You count all parts. R, 100 shaded parts. Shaded parts you count, don't the shaded. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. We have 34 shaded parts. We have 34 shaded parts. What will be the fraction of the shaded part? The fraction of shaded part will be shaded part over all of them. Hence, as a decimal, as a decimal, it will be 34 over 100. This gives you point. How many digits? 1, 2. So it will be 3, 4. Or here you have a decimal. Here we do have a decimal. You move decimal. How many steps? You move decimal. Two steps, because you have Z, you have two zeros. Two steps towards your right hand side. Hence you have 1, 2 decimal there. Hence here will be 0.34 as your answer. As your answer. That is it, plus 4. Let me give you some few assignments for you to work them out. Before I move on, allow me to shed light. We have a one-digit number over 100. A one-digit number over 100, for example, you may give it a number like 9 over 100, written as a decimal. How do you work it out, class 4? So easy, follow my step, I say, we have 9 over 100 Where is the decimal? The decimal is here. And how many steps you're going to move a decimal? You're going to move a decimal step, two steps. Towards where? You're going to move a decimal two steps towards your left hand side. Hence here, you move one step, second step, decimal there for. Hence here, you have no number put there, zero. Decimal there. Hence the answer will be 0.09. Now, having that example, it will be easier for you to work out. 2a. I can add another example of the same. A, B, C, D, 5,100. And last but not least, E. You can have a number like 8/100. That's enough for you, class 4. Try to work them out, as I'll give you more exercise immediately once I've done this. Thank you and be blessed.